After a mere 2 hours of sleep last night, a slight hangover, a turbulent flight, and 5 hours at the Baltimore airport, I'm finally in New Orleans, and this is my room. I've never stayed here before. My ex-roommate used to stay here, but I've been here before to check out the Banksy exhibit downstairs. But I like it. I like this mirror. It's definitely big, full length, and I like this little cabinet thing, which does have a mini fridge in there. I have an iron and ironing board and a blow dryer. I believe that's a blow dryer up there, but there's no safe. But I guess I'll be fine. There was a parade in front of our hotel. Don't know why. Dinner at St. John, gumbo and lemon icebox pie. Had a quick drink at the hotel bar, then went to bed early. My hotel had set up a St. Joseph's altar, since St. Joseph's Day was very soon. I appreciated that they were keeping these traditions alive. This is what one wears in New Orleans when you're going to the Irish Channel for the St. Patrick's Day Parade. Because even though there's a 15% chance of rain, it should be about 80 degrees today, and I'm gonna have to do a lot of walking. Is about to start. I managed to catch a few beads. I made it to Stein's Deli at long last. The place was packed after the parade. But I got this Italian hoagie with a pickle on the side for $12.99. So I hope it's really good. I rushed back to the quarter to see my friend's second line band. Some girl was having a second line because she was engaged, I guess. So I just ran along in front and took pictures and videos. It was fun. Met this couple in the afternoon, then ran into them again in the quarter. The hotel bartender gave me some jello shots. I slept late, then decided to go get pizza at this place right across from Louis Armstrong Park called Rampart Treehouse. I wandered around the quarter some more, admiring the architecture and so forth. And actually, my friend was having another second line. This time, I think it was for a reunion or something. And even though it rained off and on for this parade, I think it was even more fun than the day before. Creason's Fine Art Gallery because I really love his stuff. I think it's beautiful. I met him, I'm not sure how many years ago, but he's very friendly, and I try to stop in there every so often on my trips back to NOLA. I think that was a frozen Irish milkshake that I demolished. Drinks at a couple bars in the quarter, then went back to my hotel, hung out with Bay, and had drinks at the hotel bar. Baby gave me the special beads. I think these light up too, but I'm not gonna pull the little thing on it. I hope these survive the trip back. Anyway, I like them. Thank you. to the Bywater, stopped at Bywater Bakery, and got this slice of lemon chantilly cake and strawberry chocolate, which of course I'll eat later. It's going in the fridge for now. Met one of my friends for a drink at a little dive bar near my hotel. That night I was down on Frenchman Street, just wandering around. Made a stop at BMC to hear the band. Decided to have lunch at Napoleon House, wanted their warm muffaletta and some jambalaya. To Baby's Snack Box, and I was worried because some people wrote reviews like keep your head on a swivel and this and that, that it's perfectly fine over there. But Keith Lee says to go, and I'm sure that what he ordered was probably fried chicken or some sort of chicken or snowballs or something, but I got beef tamales and a chicken salad sandwich. And these tamales, they looked a little greasy and everything, but you know what? I like them. They're a little spicy. And they're like mini ones, not regular size. And the chicken salad sandwich is good too, so at least now I can say I tried it. And now, let me try a bite of this lemon chantilly cake from Bywater. It's got like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 layers. It's pink and yellow. That's good. And the chocolate strawberry one. I have so much food to eat before I leave town. I'm gonna gain 10 pounds just today. Chocolate strawberry. There's fresh strawberries in between the layers of that one. That one is good too, but I prefer the lemon chantilly one.
I said all of you, why not take all of me? Can't you see? I'm no good without you. Take my lips, I'll never lose them. Take my arms, I'll never use them. You're divine, left me with eyes that cry. How can I go on living without you? You took the part that once was my lonely heart. So why not take all of me? Give it up one more time.
Nola snacks, Chewies, Cajun nuts, Who Bigs apple pie. Since the Super Sunday parade was canceled, I decided to go uptown on St. Joseph's night to see the Mardi Gras Indians there. It was very unique, and I'm so glad that I went. Baby dropped me a present because he thought I wasn't here, so he dropped it off, and he gave me a bunch of socks, and a Saints hat, and a bunch of Zulu coconuts, which I've been waiting for a while, and some unicorn thing, which is weird because, as far as I know, he never knew that I liked unicorns. And some more beads, I guess. So, then I went out for more drinks, as if I needed any.
That's kind of why I just said that, and I'm like, I got
at the carousel bar, I met this Dutch businessman who was in town for a conference and convinced me to go out to two more bars. All I've seen.